Hi, my name is Sharon Nelson, HR manager responsible for talent acquisition for the City of Columbia. Talent in the City is our effort to highlight and showcase the departments with the City of Columbia, the department's impact players, as well as the talent who make the city run every single day. These impact players and departments oftentimes don't get the spotlight that they deserve, but without them, the City of Columbia would not run as a beautifully oiled machine that it is.
So right now we're standing inside one of the training structures, and I'm here with one of the firefighters who is an engineer. It's Keratin, and I'm so excited to talk more about this that we're in, and I want you to tell us a little bit more about what it is that you do.
Okay, so on the floor, as we call it, I'm an engineer, so I drive the trucks. I have to know the area, get us to the call or destination safely. I also pump the truck, which means I send the water to put the fire out. And I'm pretty much just a bridge between my firefighters and my captain.
So you would be the person that would stay inside the vehicle?
Yes.
During the fire?
Well, not inside the vehicle. It's a pump panel, so I pull levers, as we call it, and make sure I'm getting water from the hydrants.
Awesome. And you have two roles with the fire department. Tell us about that.
I'm an engineer, also down in training. I'm an adjunct instructor, I'm one of them. So I pretty much take the recruits, I put them through various skills and teach them pretty much how we would do it on the floor and how the fire academy would like us to teach them.
Awesome. And I think it's only fair for us to let our viewers actually hear from someone who is actually a part of the fire department. Tell us, what was it that made you want to be a fireman?
So being born and raised here in Columbia, I love to help people. So that was the deciding factor for me. I actually applied at other departments. I was in Spartanburg first, and they called me, and I was excited to come back and give forth my efforts to helping the citizens here.
And what's the most rewarding part of your job? Is there anything, any memories that stand out to you?
Mostly just helping people, seeing them smile, you know, that hearing them to say thank you after a call, and thanking us for our service every day.
I love it. Thank you so much.
No problem. So it starts in the truck, we pop the brake, you put in what's called pump gear. So right now it's in pump. You come here. Safety first, wheel chalk so the truck can't move. At this time, my firefighter will be pulling the line. So from there, I just make sure it's all pulled off. While in the process, making sure I charge the right line, right? So right here, it'll tell me the color and which line it is, which is the passenger discharge. Now come back over here. We actually have to do math for this. So if you if you're not good at math, you pretty much just gotta learn it on your own, which we do have driving classes. So first off, we put it in pressure mode, or we call it PSI mode, and then we charge it, right? From there, I am tank the pump. That sends water to the pump from my tank, and you tank fill to keep the pump from overheating. Then it's already open, so I just charge it. And while that's doing that, I'm hooking up my hydrant. Call for water. That would be another engineer there charging it, and once the water get there, I just let it go from my hydrant and I refill my tank. Once we go out the hydrant, we just pretty much using our tank as a backup in case something goes wrong.
Here's the moment that we've all been waiting for. How else can I be able to illustrate what it takes to do this job without dressing out myself? So Chief, I need you to tell me, first of all, how heavy is this gear that you're wearing today?
So typically it's about anywhere from 5 to 10 pounds. Again though, a lot of sweat comes out of a human body, so with the sweat, it can be anywhere from 20 to 25 pounds with the sweat. And it's 3 layers of gear, so it can get pretty heavy.
And what type of insulation is in here?
So you have 3 layers. You have a moisture barrier, an outer shell, and an interior barrier protecting you. I told you it keeps heat out, but it also keeps a lot of heat in. So firefighters are actually getting really hot with this on. However, once we come out and we rehab, we'll open the gear up and we'll cool down.
And is this something that you can put on yourself, or do you need help? Is this something you need to be assisted with?
No, ma'am. Every firefighter should be able to put this gear on in their sleep when they're leaving for school. So from the beginning of week one, recruits are trained to put the gear on properly and efficiently and quickly.
Awesome. Well, let's get started. I'm ready. So right. We have everything here. Tell me about these pieces that we're going to be putting on as you help me put them on.
Okay, so right here I have for you, this is your flash hood. This is going to protect your face and your ears. Very important.
Okay.
From heat. Put that on first.
Where was this during COVID?
yeah.
I knew not to be real cute today.
Yes. Is that everybody?
All right.
So that's your flash hood, all right? And this is going to be your jacket piece.
We're done? If you ever wondered what it's like to be a baked potato, here's your chance. My chance. Wow, this is pretty heavy. Yeah, I will be in the truck. I'll be in the truck.
Try to get your hands all the way through if you can. And your thumb should go through that little loop right here.
If they're not done by then, we'll hang out.
Oh my goodness. I feel like I'm getting ready for war. It feels.
Okay.
Awesome. So I'm dressed out, but of course, are all three layers in this?
Yes. So this is your outer shell, what we talked about. This is the outer shell of the jacket. And this is your inner moisture barrier. And then inside here, this is a more additional layer.
We have a website, colafire.net. And they can come there, and there's an entrance form, felt entrance form. Then they'll get a call from me. And that could be for volunteering, or if they're interested in a career opportunity, they can do that. And also go to the City of Columbia website. And as soon as they go there, they scroll down a little bit, and there's a blue box with different icons, and there's one that says job opportunities. They click on that, then there's a box that type in firefighter, and they'll see there's opportunity for certified firefighters or non-certified, and they click on one of those and fill out an application, and they'll get a call.
Perfect. Well, Chief Kip, thank you so much again, and we're going to continue to be with the City of Columbia as we talk about some of these various vacancies throughout the Midlands. So if you are looking again for a job and you want a career, make sure that you stick around. Thank you.
For more information about this position and its department, please visit www.columbiasc.gov.